Volcanic eruptions, when they occur, can change the landscape forever. These changes can range from adding new land to expand a landmass, rerouting an existing river, to connecting two separate islands. However, since a large volume of volcanic rock or ash is needed to accomplish any of these feats, such occurrences are generally thought of as quite negative. Yet, in a select few set of circumstances, a major change in topography caused by a volcanic eruption can make the land more, not less valuable in the long term. One example of a positive change in the long term occurred at the Hakoneyama volcano in Japan. If you were to have hypothetically visited this volcano 3,500 years ago, you would have seen a blocky and fairly rugged landscape with domes and fumaroles that did not have a consistent water source, only containing two small rivers which were sometimes dry. However, this would all change after a magmatic intrusion began greatly destabilizing a section of Mount Hakone. Eventually, the associated magma which triggered this activity got shallow enough that it interacted with the area's water table. This water then flashed to steam and produced a powerful blast in what is known as a phreatic eruption, setting 200 million cubic meters of rock in motion. This occurred in 1400 BCE. In only a minute's time, the associated landslide swept across the landscape at speeds of up to 175 miles per hour or 281 kilometers per hour before finally coming to a rest over a 5.8 square kilometer patch of ground which reached up to 4,700 meters from the landslide's source. This landslide filled what was previously a small valley that was 125 feet deep with sufficient volume to completely block off two sections of it. As a result, over time, what was once a small river that occasionally ran was now completely dammed, and this created the famous Lake Ashi. Today, this lake is visited by 15 million people each year, bringing abundant revenue to those who live nearby, which also made adjacent properties substantially more valuable than they otherwise would have been if the specific eruption-caused landslide had never occurred. To further prove this concept, let us compare real estate prices. Right adjacent to Lake Ashi, a 3,368 square meter patch of land, aka 0.83 acres of land with no structures on it, is selling for 220 million yen. Yet, if we instead look at a house 8.5 kilometers to the west-southwest, it is selling for 10 million yen. The price of other structures within the caldera is also elevated due to the attraction of this lake, with a similarly sized house being sold for 78 million yen. The Hakoneyama volcano encompasses a series of vents spread across an area of 440 square kilometers. Much like Mount Fuji to the west-northwest, Hakoneyama exists due to the presence of three tectonic plate boundaries, which include the Philippine Sea Plate, Okhotsk Plate, and the Amurian Plate. Hakone could best be described as a grouping of narrowly spaced volcanic cones and lava domes that were intermittently active throughout its 400,000-year-long history. Many of these vents formed along a northwest-facing chain of activity that parallels a section of a nearby tectonic plate boundary. During the early stages of this volcano, numerous Volcanian and Strombolian eruptions similar to what is today seen at Guatemala's Fuego volcano occurred, which constructed a 2,000-meter-high red-top stratovolcano. However, at depth, Hakone's magma chamber was becoming larger and more volatile-rich. Eventually, this reached such a point that three powerful ultra-planean eruptions occurred 190,000, 181,000, and 178,000 years ago. These three VEI-6 eruptions caused the existing stratovolcano to collapse, with the summit region losing 1,300 meters in height and forming a 12-kilometer-wide caldera. A second singular caldera-forming eruption occurred 67,500 years ago, which ejected 20 cubic kilometers of tephra and expanded the existing caldera's size. All of Hakone's vents within this caldera formed after the fact, largely through Merapi-type Volcanian eruptions. The last two eruptions from this volcano occurred in approximately the same location where fumaroles exist and the ground is highly altered, with phreatic eruptions occurring in the early 13th century and a single event that formed a complex explosion crater in 2015. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.